as a blow shoots up through the stony ground. There's no room, no space to rent in this town. You're out of luck, and the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck.
Chickpea fritter was the original sandwich. We started up about 4 years ago over at MIT. And we started up just originally, we're only going to be open for like 6 weeks in order to get feedback from customers, tweak our recipes, and make improvements to our food. So at this point, 4 years later, with all the feedback that we've received from customers, we're on almost version 40. So it's always changing, and we're still developing it now, people have said in the 2 years that I've worked here. So that includes changes to the falafel batter itself, different spices, the method we use one of the changes I've witnessed is the seasoning on the cucumber and tomato salad. When I first started, we seasoned it with a bunch of mint and za'atar and all these different spices, but now we just reduced it down to simple salt and a little lemon juice.
Okay.
And you're not moving anywhere.
Depends on the season. Vegetables don't grow year-round here in Massachusetts, unfortunately, but during the summer, I'd say, aside from the and the ingredients in the falafel works 100%. So all the vegetables would be local.
You thought you found a friend.
We work with a ton of different farms. I know right now we're getting our parsnips from a farm out in Waverly, Mass. There are farms all over the place based on what they're growing and what we're featuring.
Okay, so there's not a main farm that you guys have been working at? Whoever you can get. Okay.
To take you out of this place.
Whenever we can get them, yes.
Okay, so not necessarily just a meal.
We don't advertise that we're organic, but whenever possible we use organic.
You can lend a hand.
Pricing or availability. Again, growing seasons based on where things are produced organically. Sometimes we can't get organic cabbage because the farms that grow it aren't producing it.
A hand in return for grace.
I believe so.
Do you know who the supplier is? Okay, that's fine. Yeah, or the falafel? Do you know the pita?
The pita we use a baker down in Brooklyn.
Okay. Do you know the baker's name?
We've recently changed, and I don't know the new one.
Okay.
It's been like
who was
a
the
month
old
ago.
One? Just so we.
It used to be a bakery called Pita Express.
Okay.
Now we're actually looking at bringing that in house, baking our own bread here in Boston.
Oh, nice. And would that just be done at the restaurants or? Okay.
Yeah, at our commissary in Cambridge.
But you got no destination.
It's made me more conscious about where our food's coming from. We have a big CSA, Community Supported Agriculture Program, too, so we work with, right now we're working with 6 different farms to bring our customers fresh local vegetables, and that's never something I had considered doing in the past. This is going to be my second summer here.
Cool, nice!
It's always fun to get a big box of who knows what.
Is that, and what season is that?
It starts at the end of May, beginning of June. And then it
goes
last through October.
Okay.
I don't think it makes it more or less difficult. Yeah. It's just a conscious decision that we made.
Cool.
Again, we never set out to be a food truck company. It just happened to work out that way, but we have more food trucks than restaurants. But had we just been a restaurant, I think we'd have the same focus.